So please, what's One Nigeria all about?
It's about trying to get government to work for every Nigerian, not just for the rich or for the people who can get the president to defend them against charges of corruption. The government is not working. It's clear that the government appears to have come on a false prospectus, and we're saying enough is enough. You have a yellow card, fix it, or you get a red card.
So what is it about headsmen you're talking about? Food and all
everything.
That.
Everything. Food prices, food is unaffordable, electricity is unaffordable, Nigerians can't send their children to school, we can't evacuate our foods to the market, we can't get our kids to school, enough is enough.
Is it the same?
Insecurity, Nigerians are being killed everywhere.
Yeah. Is it the same, this is a match that Tuface Idibia is supposed to participate
where
in?
Every Nigerian has a right to match.
Okay, thank you very much.
My name is Dixon Irebu. My Oga mentioned Nollywood. I'm a key stakeholder in Nollywood. I'm a film producer director.
We know you.
So that by all means, Nollywood is represented here too. We're all Nigerians.
Great.
In fact, that's the only product proudly made in Nigeria.
Yes.
I am very excited that God gave me the grace to be part of this process that we took today. Very, very excited. I'm very, very excited because I told myself, I announced it on Facebook, I announced it on all my social platforms that I was going to be here. Tuface, yes, our friend, our brother. Personally, I told him he chickened out, but we're not chickening out. But then, we have also appreciated that, yes, the fact that he identified with this move is enough to say well done.
Yes.
But young people today should appreciate this very day, that your government should never intimidate you.
Yes.
It is wrong.
Absolutely.
It is very wrong for us to sit back at home and be tweeting and abusing on social platforms. But when they say let's protest, we all sit back at home. It is wrong. That's cowardice. Today we have proven that we're not cowards. Today also we have also seen that the security outfits are not particularly killers.
Yes.
Some group may have invaded their mists when they shoot down at any of those groups that they have shot down at. Today we have seen how civil they could be with us. We appreciate them, the security, the police, we appreciate you. But we also want you to know that this is your fight. This is yours, really. Baba, wherever you are, we wish you well, that you come back home. Nigerians are asking that you come back home. Face it squarely, if you want to resign, sir, you could resign. But if you wouldn't, fix our nation, make those promises that you made available. Trump, on arrival, started moving immediately. So there are no excuses anymore. We appreciate that our nation may have faced some issues before now, but that's why you asked for this mandate for 12 years. For 12 years, you asked for this mandate. Somehow you even wept and gave up and said you weren't doing again. And we said, okay, come. Nigerians called you out. I made you president. You promised.
My name is Aisha Yesufu, and I'm a Nigerian citizen that is frustrated. I'm tired of all the atrocities that have been happening in this country. I am tired of the fact that a poor person in this country is nameless, faceless, and voiceless. I am tired of the fact that I will sit at home and there will be all sorts of things that will be done to me and nobody will be there for me as a citizen. Insecurity is on the rise in this country, kidnappings are going on, and there is no emergency plan. There's nothing being put on ground to checkmate that. Children are being taken away in their schools. Villages are being ransacked, villages are being razed down, and nothing is being done about it. And I'm a Nigerian that is tired of all of that. There has been a lot of impunity in this country. We have certain things going on. I'm tired of our leaders going abroad to go and get the best health care, while here in Nigeria, the people that they govern and they get their money from and they get whatever it is that they have for, they have left us alone to deal with the things that are not there in our hospitals. I am tired of the fact that I don't have 24 hours power supply. I am tired of the fact that I have to put on a generator. If I don't have to, I don't have a generator, I will stay in darkness. I am tired of the fact that I am my own government. I provide my own security. I provide myself. I educate my children. I pay for health care and I pay taxes and I don't get anything out of it. And at the end of the day, there is so much impunity in the sense that our leaders look at us and tell